The following is a class from the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 9th chapter, text number 23, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in December of 1966 in New York.
Jitpanna Jivata Bhaktya Jajante Sadhyanita. मामी वकंथिया जजंती अविधि पूर्वक वर्शिप ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड एंड वर्शिप ऑफ अदर डेमी गॉड्स दैट इज बीइंग डिस्कस्ड इन दिस वर्स माय लॉर्ड श्री कृष्ण एक्चुअली देर इज नो नीड ऑफ वर्शिपिंग any demigod beside the Supreme. But in the lower stage, just like the other day we have discussed, because we cannot immediately give up our concept of material existence and material happiness and material distress, we take into consideration very seriously, without any spiritual life or without any idea of spiritual existence. Therefore, sometimes recommended in the Vedic literature that for this purpose you can worship this demigod. Just like the other day I gave you the example that those who are diseased, they are recommended to worship the sun god. There are different kinds of desires. One who wants beautiful wife, he has been recommended to worship Uma, the wife of Lord Shiva. In this way, there are hundreds of demigods, and we have got hundreds of desires. Just that one who wants to eat flesh, he is advised to worship Goddess Kali. Because the Vedic literature will not allow to have a regular slaughterhouse. No, that cannot be. But still, those who want the facility of eating flesh, they are advised that, all right, you worship Goddess Kali and sacrifice a goat before the goddess and eat it. But there is a great list of formulas to make that, I mean to say, sacrifice of goat. Not that I take a goat or cow to the slaughterhouse and cut it. No, that is not enough. The idea is to restrict him, not to encourage him. Just like not in your country, in our country, there is prohibition. In some cities there is strictly prohibition. No wine can be available. But still there are wine shops under government license. So these wine shops does not mean to encourage citizen to come and drink wine. No. The idea is to restrict those who cannot live without liquor. For them there is some concession, because one must live after all. Similarly, one who cannot avoid meat eating, for him that demigod, Goddess Kali. But unfortunately, some foolish persons, they have advertised like Goddess Kali worshiping, he has become God. These are all foolish things. This recommendation, here it is said by Lord Sinha, Tipi Mame Vakantya, that worship of different demigods is indirectly offering worship to me, because they are my representative. But Abhidhipur Bhakam. Abhidhipur Bhakam, it is not prescribed. Abhidhipur Bhakam. It is, what is called in English, which is not legal. Illegal. Not violated. Something which is not allowed by law, but sometimes some concession is given. Anyway, it is clearly stated here, avidhipurvakam. Then vidhipurvakam also, vidhipurvakam is under regulation. That's right, in your body, you have to take special care of your stomach, the digesting machine for your foodstuff. If your digestion is all right, then the energy will be supplied equal to the all parts of the body. So, that is necessary. But at the same time, it is not prohibited that you should not take care of the hand, which is a part of your mouth. That's all. Similarly, to worship any god may be accepted if people know that these demigods are authorized agents of the Supreme Law. There is acceptance of Supreme Law. But those fools who do not accept the Supreme Law and misunderstand that this particular type of demigod is all enough, they are doing nonsense. They are placing so many competitors of the Supreme Law. That is avidhipurvakam. That is illegal. Nobody can be competitor of the Supreme Law. The Supreme Lord is known as asamodha, asama audha. Nobody is greater than the Supreme Lord and nobody is equal on the same level. Everyone, whatever he may be, however powerful he may be, they are all living entities. There are innumerable living entities and some of them are by degree. One is powerful more than the other. So, in the material world, we can see that Brahma, Lord Brahma is the most powerful demigod. Similarly, Lord Shiva is also next to Brahma or equal to Brahma. Somebody says he is more than Brahma, whatever it may be. So, Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma are considered to be the most powerful demigod. But still, it is prohibited that one should not think of them as equal to the Supreme Law. It is strictly prohibited in Vaishnava Purana. It is said like this, Jastu Narayanam Devam. Jastu Narayanam Devam Brahma Rudradi Devatai Samatrena Vikheta Sa Pashandi Bhavet Dhruvam. Any person who keeps on the same level demigods like Brahma Rudra, that means Brahma and Lord Shiva, with Narayan. Narayan is the Supreme Lord. Jastu Narayanam Devam Brahma Rudradi Devatai. They are very big demigods, but even they cannot be placed on the equal level of Narayan, the Supreme Lord. Just to samaptena vikheta, anyone says that to me everyone is the same. He is pasandi. His pasandi means non-faithful, unfaithful, unbeliever. He is pasandi. Savhasandi bhavadhuvam. He is unbeliever. He has no faith in God. He is unbeliever. So, if he worship demigods as part and parcel of the Supreme Law, then it is all right. But if we accept a particular type of demigod as he is the Lord, then that is irregular. That is not That is not accepted here in the Bhagavad Gita. Avidhi purvaka. Aham hi sarvajagyanam bhoktata prahurevata nasumam abhijananti tattena atas chavantite. The Lord says, I am the only enjoyer, beneficiary of all kinds of sacrifices. Aham hi bhokta, aham hi sarvajagyanam bhokta. Bhokta means enjoyer. Just like in the office or in the factory, so many workers, they are working day and night, producing money. But who is the bhokta? Who is the enjoyer? The enjoyer is the proprietor. They are not enjoyer. They are laborers. They are workers. Similarly, any kind of worship, any kind of sacrifice, any kind of charity, any kind of penance, any kind of austerity, any kind of philosophical discussion, any kind of meditation. There are so many things recommended for self-realization or the Supreme Absolute Truth realization. The Lord Krishna says, all those processes, the ultimate beneficiary is I am, myself, Lord Krishna. Aham hi sarvajagyanam bhokta, prabhu revas, master. Prabhu means master. Natumam abhijananti, people do not know me. Natumam abhijananti, that Krishna is the supreme enjoyer, the absolute enjoyer. We are all enjoyed. There are two things, enjoyer and the enjoyed. Just like a crude example can be given. That a husband and wife, the husband is supposed to be the enjoyer and the wife is supposed to be the enjoyed. But the enjoyment is the same for both. But if you make division, it is understood that the husband is predominated and the wife is predominated. So here, Prabhu means he is the predominator and everyone is predominated. Everyone. Therefore, those who are predominated, their duty is to satisfy the predominator. And when the predominator is satisfied, both the predominator and the predominated get the equal result. So, the Vaishnava philosophy, they want to remain predominated by the supreme predominator. And the Mahabharata philosophy, the monist, they want to merge into the predominator. Their idea is to become themselves predominator. When they fail to become predominator in this material world, we are all trying to become predominator. Everyone is trying. Bhokta. And the competition is going on. You are some predominator. Over 1,000 of workers or office clerks, your office is so big, so I want to make my office bigger than you. So I want to become greater predominator than you. This is our competition is going. But none of us is actually predominator. We are all predominated. And because we do not know that I can never be a predominator, therefore I am under illusion, maya. The real predominator is the Supreme Lord Krishna. Aham hi sarvajagyanam bhokta prabhu revas, he is the predominator. Natumabhavi Ananti. People, they do not know. They want to become predominators themselves. But that is not possible. By nature, it is not so. I want to be predominated. But actually, I am being predominated by my desires, by my lust, by my anger, by my avarice, and so many good qualities. They are controlling me. I am angry, so I tell you something. Nonsense, you see. So that I am predominated by the anger, kama krodha. So therefore, one who knows that I am not predominator, I am predominated. Suppose I am the head of the family. I am thinking that I am head of the family. But I am being controlled by the family members. I want to satisfy my wife, I want to satisfy my children, and if they are unsatisfied, then there is destruction in my family. Suppose I want to become the president. So my business will be to keep the citizens satisfied. Otherwise, next vote, I shall not get the post. So I am being predominated by the voting power. But I am thinking that I am predominated. This is Kali Yuga. Nobody is predominated. He is predominated by some other principle. Therefore, one who knows this, one who does not know, natumāma vijānanti, one who does not know, tattena tas chabantite, they fall down under the illusion, chabantite. And one who knows that I can never become the predominator, I shall always remain the predominated. If I do not become predominated voluntarily by the Supreme Lord, if I do not surrender unto Him and voluntarily agree to be predominated by the Lord, then I shall be predominated by the elements of material nature. This kama, krodha, lobha, lust, desire, anger, enviousness, so many things, they will predominate. The senses will predominate. Actually, you are, at the present moment, you are servants of the senses. My senses dictate something, I am obliged to do it. I cannot avoid it. Very simple thing. As soon as my tongue dictates, please walk. Immediately I have to take one cigarette. Immediately. If somebody does not smoke, then he asks permission. Sometimes we do not smoke. Sometimes some gentleman comes and he becomes too much agitated by not smoking, say, 5 minutes or 10 minutes. He asks permission. Finally, can I smoke? He's being predominated. He does not know. He is thinking that I am smoking. But he does not know that smoking is eating him. He is thinking that I am enjoying LSD. But LSD is killing him. This is the position. It's killing. So, because he does not know that who is the predominator, therefore, chavanti, he's falling down. He's falling down. The best thing is intelligence. Best intelligence is to accept Supreme Lord Krishna as the predominator and be predominated by Him. That is our natural life. One who does not know, he falls down. Natumāma vijānanti tattena. Sattina, my truth. Simply to know Krishna. Krishna was somebody born in India. And he was very powerful. And he was very intelligent. He has written Bhagavad Gita. But we do not know actually what Krishna is. And this society is specially meant to broadcast the knowledge about Krishna. Therefore, we have named particularly this society, the Society for Krishna Consciousness. Here is it. The people do not know it. They are writing commentaries on Krishna's book. But they are speaking nonsense because they do not know Krishna. Satyena Shravanti, they fall down from the truth. This is. So therefore, we should try to know Krishna by parampara system. Krishna is delivering his instruction to Arjuna. And if we understand, as Arjuna understood, that is mentioned in the 10th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, then we can understand Krishna to some extent. We cannot understand Krishna in full, that is not possible. Because he is unlimited, and we are limited. So, our power will fail to understand Krishna fully. But if we understand something, something about him, just like in the Bhagavad Gita, we find, janma karmam divyam je janati tattva. Taksadiham punajanma naiti mameti kaunteya. My dear Arjuna, anyone who simply knows how I take my birth and how I am working, janma karma, maybe transcendentally, that person becomes immediately liberated. How is that? Na taksadiham. After quitting this body, he never comes again to this material world. Then where does he go? Mameti, in my kingdom. So simply by knowing how Krishna is unborn, how he is taking birth, and is supreme, how he is working like us, these two things if we know simply about Krishna. So how do we know? Therefore, the Vedic injunction is Sadvijnanartham sa guru meva abhidhacchet. If you want to know Krishna, then you must approach a person who knows Krishna. Don't try to know Krishna by your own imagination. People are trying to know Krishna by faulty imagination. In that way, Krishna cannot be known. So if we want to know Krishna, then you have to know Krishna as Arjuna known. Because Arjuna understood Krishna, what he is. Otherwise, he would not have changed his decision. His decision was not to fight, but he changed his decision. He fought because he understood Krishna. He understood Krishna. So, here it is stated, Natumam Abhijananti. People do not know. I am the beneficiary, I am the enjoyer of everything, I am the lord of everything. Therefore, everything should be done for me, everything should be offered to me. That will make him happy, peace. We are hankering after peace. But did you not know what is peace? You are unnecessarily, illegally claiming over lordship on Krishna's property. How we can be in peace? The material agent, the material energy is there. Suppose if I encroach upon another's property, will it be peaceful? The police action is already there. Why the police is there? So that one may not encroach upon others' rights. Police is there. The law and law and order department. Department of law and order. So there, why that is? That everyone should be free to enjoy his right. So you cannot encroach upon others' right. But here, in our material conception of life, our only business is to encroach upon the rights of others. That is our business. We are all encroaching on the rights of others. That is our business. So how you can expect peace? I do not allow even a poor animal to live. I am encroaching upon his body. The poor animal is living at the cost of God, but I am encroaching upon his life, and still we want to establish our right. We encroach upon others' property, others' land, and we want peace. How there can be peace? Our business is to encroach upon others' property, and we want to be peaceful, that there cannot be peaceful. The foolish action is there. Similarly, the material nature is the foolish action of the Supreme Lord. As the state is protected by the Department of Law and Order, similarly, this whole universe is protected by the stringent laws of nature. If we violate the stringent laws of nature, we not, excuse me, even a children, if he transgresses the law of nature, if he touches fire, the fire will not excuse, because he is a child. No. Ignorance is no excuse. Similarly, everything, the Prabhu, the Supreme Lord, God is the proprietor of everything. Ahame sarva jagyanam bhuktata prabhurevata. Natumama vijananti. They do not know that God is the proprietor of everything, so they are encroaching upon God's property and nature is punishing. This is awful. You cannot avoid. Devi dhesa gunamai mama maya durutya. The law of nature is very strong and stringent. Just a small example. A child catching fire. Fire does not excuse. Let's see how much stringent law of nature. So law of nature is very stringent. So everything belongs to Krishna or the Supreme Lord, and we do not know it. And therefore we are encroaching upon the property of Krishna, and law is the law of nature punishing us. This is wrong. Then if you want to stop this, then you have to surrender to the law. Māme vaja prapadnanti māyā me tāṁ taranti. Anyone who surrenders unto the Supreme, he becomes away from the stringent laws of nature. He becomes peaceful. He becomes happy. One who is in Krishna consciousness, he is happy. He is peaceful. He does not do any harm to anyone, not even to the ant. What to speak of other animals? He enjoys according to the direction of Krishna. And enjoys very nicely. So his life becomes peaceful, happy, and everything that is desirable. He becomes qualified with all the good qualities. Jashasti bhakti bhagavata kinchana sarvai gunai tatra samasati sura. Anyone who becomes Krishna consciousness, all the good qualities automatically develop. They develop. Sarava bhakta satuto mahadguna. And one who is not in Krishna consciousness, he has no good qualification at all. Why? Manorathena asato dhar. Because he is hovering over the mental plane. He has no more any touch with the spiritual plane. So long we are on the material plane, or gross bodily plane, or subtle mental plane, we have to suffer. We have to go to the spiritual platform. And that spiritual platform is Krishna consciousness. We have to change the consciousness from material platform, from mental platform, from intellectual platform, to the platform of Krishna. That is our program, Krishna consciousness. If we become fully Krishna conscious, there is no chance of falling down. If you do not become, then there is always chance of falling down, 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 down. Thank you very much.